So, hello, Dr. Devika. How are
Hi,
you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Well, I'm very good, thank you. Welcome to Inspiring Minds. So, we have our another session today of the MCI success story, and I would just like you to introduce yourself to our audience.
Hello, everyone. I'm Devika Mayankar. I graduated from Przewalski Research State Medical University in June 2019. I came back to India in July and I took FMG December 2019 and cleared it in my first attempt with a score of 172 out of 300.
Okay, so congratulations for that, first of all.
Thank you.
In this video, we are going to basically focus on the strategy part. And we're going to talk about your strategy and how you think it worked for you. And we have a set of questions. So without wasting any time, let's get directly onto it. So yeah, the first question is, which everyone wants to know is, when did you start and what was your initial preparation strategy and how was your timeline actually? Like for 5-6 months or you started in your college days already, so how was it?
So I graduated and I came back to India on 13 July and I was preparing on my own using an app online. I did not go to Delhi. So I started my preparation on 15th of July. I had about 5 months in hand for preparation. And
okay.
Initially I focused on the basic subjects, the preclinicals,
mm-hmm.
and then I shifted to the clinical part. I did not study as such for MCI, dedicated MCI preparation. I did not do during my university days.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So you basically started just after you came to India, right?
Yes, right.
Okay. And that too in just 5 months.
Yes.
Very good. So yes, as you already said that you did not come to Delhi and you did not join any coaching institute, which is like the traditional way, if I would say. So how did you manage to do complete preparation just via the online resources or the applications that we have these days? So what, according to you, is the difference between these two and what all are the advantages and disadvantages of both the online and offline thing?
So initially, during graduation, I was a little skeptical about how I need to go about the FMG preparation, because all my university mates were going through the traditional route, but because of some personal reasons I could not join them. So there was a friend of mine who told me that it really doesn't matter as long as you are sitting at home and you are studying religiously for say 8 to 10 hours at least a day, and you have your strategy, then it really doesn't matter whether you attend coaching or you study from home, because the preparation schedule and the material that is provided is the same, whether you join an app, you study through an app, or you join one-on-one coaching like in Delhi. When you join coaching, they provide you with a timeline for each subject. For example, which subject is going to take how many days, how many hours. When you study on your own, you need to figure it out on your own. It takes maybe a couple of days to understand your speed and the topics that you really need to focus on. So ultimately, I think with question solving and through repeated revision, you ultimately make it.
Okay, so if I have to ask you... carry on.
A lot of discipline that you need to...
Exactly.
Continue with the preparation, because when you know that you are joining a coaching center, you know that the class is going to start at 7 a.m. So you reach there by hook or by crook. But when you're studying at home, you need to have that dedication that yes, I'm going to wake up on time and I'm going to watch this today and solve these many questions, which is a little difficult, I would say.
Okay, so you know what I think is, as we go abroad for our medicine career, we just go after like the AIPMT. It was AIPMT at our time. I guess by your time also, it was All India Pre-Medical Test. As you're from Mumbai, it must be MHT-CET, I guess.
No, that particular year, we did not have MHT-CET. We had NEET UG.
Okay.
It was
okay, it
the
started
first year
from
of
your
NEET.
Year. Okay. So for that, you used to have the set coaching institutes and everything. And after that 6 long years of medicine, then we tend to go like, no, we need something formal. And application and the online stuff is something, as you already said, it needs discipline and the dedication. So just to continue, how did you manage to do that? How did you maintain the discipline? Like, no, I have to start at this time. I have to finish this much lectures and I have to make these many notes. So how was it?
So I'm actually used to self-study. I've never been to any coaching, even in childhood. So I have a habit of planning and going as per my own route, finding my own way. So initially, I've actually asked a lot of people about FMG preparation during my undergraduate days. So that kind of helped me. And the app that I got, they tell you the number of hours of videos for each subject. And on the FCI website, you have the marking scheme for each subject. So you know which subjects are actually important and which subjects you really need to focus on. So I started with basic subjects like physiology, biochemistry first. And the first subject I started was biochemistry, which is actually, it was short, I think 26 hours of videos. But it took me about a week to complete it, which is a lot, I think. But yeah, that time I was just figuring out as to how many hours I need to devote for videos and then MCQ particular.
Okay, so very good. Now to start with the subjects, what all subjects you think were easy, like were easy to grasp when you had a good grip on those subjects? So what were those subjects? Like you think they really played a major role in the score that you received?
In preclinicals, I would say physiology, biochemistry, pathology, PSM are very important. And the most important in preclinicals is PSM because it has a lot of weightage. I think 30-35 questions are easily from PSM itself.
Correct. Yes.
And in the clinical part, I would say obstetrics and gynae is the most important. There were many, I think around 35 or 40 questions during our exam. Then, and the small subjects are actually more important in the clinical part. Dermatology, psychiatry, FMT is also important. And pediatrics, not many questions, but it is scoring. So that helps. Yeah. About 3 to 5 questions from pediatrics, you can easily get all correct.
Okay, so as you've already discussed about some of the subjects, what was your basic monthly plan? Like what all subjects you started with? As you said, you started off with the biochemistry for you, which took around a week as you were analyzing everything and making your timetable and schedule. So how did you maintain the pace after that? And how did you go monthly? Like how was it?
So I realized that I used to get very bored with a single subject a day. So I divided my day in such a way that initially I used to wake up early in the morning at around 5:36. I would start studying at 7. So 7 to 11, I would watch videos of a big subject. And then till about 2, I would solve MCQs related to that subject with breaks, of course, in between. Every 2 hours, I would take a break of 10-15 minutes. And in the second half of the day after lunch, from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock, I would study a small subject, say dermatology, psychiatry, or orthopedics. And in the evening, I used to take a walk or go somewhere outside, meet a few friends of mine. And then at night, 1 hour, I used to solve MCQs of the small subject.
Okay.
And that's it. My day would end at around 8:39. Then dinner, and then I used to sleep only.
Okay, so what you want to say is you did not focus on any one particular subject for the whole day. You made your own segments. Okay. So was it any particular plan to match up the subjects or you took the random subjects?
No, I had a plan. I started with biochemistry, then physiology. Along with that, I finished PSM pharmacology, I did not study at a stretch. I used to study every day 1 hour. And in the month of, say, August, 1 month, I devoted to these two subjects. And in August, what happened is I had to change my place of study to another city because of some shifting. End of August, I started with clinical subjects. The first subject that I studied was obs gyne because I think that is the easiest in the clinical part, because you don't have to memorize anything in obs gyne. It's all understanding based, so it's easier to grasp. It doesn't take a lot of days, also about 5-6 days for obs gyne. And along with that, I continued small subjects daily, little by little. So initially, I wanted to finish it by October end, because on 2nd November, there was an OMG test, but I couldn't. I finished about 13 subjects, but I still took the All India FMG test. It's important not to wait till you finish everything, because that is impossible. So in the first test that I took, I scored 140 on 300, which was not a passing mark. I was 10 marks short. But when I reviewed, I understood that the problem was just recall. I knew the material, but I couldn't recollect it in that time frame. Okay. So from 2nd November, I started revising along with the subjects that I had left.
Okay, so when you've already mentioned about the mock test, how did you utilize the mock test properly? How can one do that? Like, just giving a test is something else, and then analyzing it and introspecting your mistakes and reviewing it, the other options and everything, how should one do that?
So initially, the app had topic-wise questions as well, and I was using FMG solutions also. So as I finished 2-3 topics, I used to solve questions. And then when I finish a particular subject, I would take test for that particular subject. I scored really low in first few tests. Not a passing, in fact, barely passing. But then it's important. Of course, you feel low, but it's important to review each question and to analyze as to how you went wrong, why you thought a certain way, and why the answer was actually something else. So when I reviewed all of that, I went back to the notes and I read it once again, just to make sure that it remains in my head for a long time.
So you made your own notes, or you used the same application notes?
No, I did not. I don't make notes. I just use the printed notes that they provided. But I did make notes only for internal medicine. I made my handwritten notes for internal medicine.
Okay, so now when you have mentioned about the internal medicine, so now let's talk about the big subjects like the internal medicine and surgery. So how, and PSM, how do they play a major role in someone's grade score, and how can one not pass without going after these subjects?
So PSM, I think among these three, PSM is the most important, because about 30-35 questions, you can easily score 25 to 30, because they are that's a learning subject. You have to memorize a lot in it. But at the same time, it was difficult for me because I could not memorize all of it at a stretch. So as I told you, I divided it into a month, one topic a day, so I wouldn't get bored. For internal medicine, I would say I was pretty good even when I had not finished the subject. I think it was taught a little better in our university, so I didn't have an issue. But I don't think you need to invest more than 5-6 days for internal medicine. It's not very scoring. And you can answer questions based on your knowledge from pathology, pharmacology, physiology also. But one skim through it would help.
Okay, so continuing the same thing. If one just cannot complete these subjects, like for say medicine, So what all are the important topics or segments one should go after if they don't have that much time or if they just cannot complete all the 19 subjects per se?
In surgery, honestly, general surgery is the most important. And questions are asked mostly on types of sutures or types of wounds and maybe breast, thyroid, and all of that. In internal medicine, I think respiratory and cardiology is the most important. With renal, internal medicine are also important.
Yeah.
A lot of questions are asked on renal as well. And PSM, I think everything is important.
Yeah.
Because they can ask anything in PSM. You don't really have a particular syllabus for PSM.
True, true. Yeah, it has some part of medicine as well, like the infectious disease and everything.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I think PSM covers a lot of pediatrics and internal medicine also.
True. Because even of some part of the, I guess, some part of gynecology as well, like the oral contraceptive.
Yes, right.
Yeah. Okay, so coming to the next question, is finishing all the subjects important or possible?
Firstly, it is not possible, and secondly, it is not even important because FMG exam doesn't test if you know everything. You just have to get that 150 and you are ready to go ahead. For that, what you need more than finishing the curriculum is constant revision. So I would say even if you are finished, have finished 14, 15 subjects thoroughly, it's good. You are well to go. But from those 14, 15 subjects, you need to focus on the subjects that are high yield. Like, as I mentioned, if you waste a lot of time in surgery, internal medicine, then it's going to take a lot of time of your preparation and you won't really score as much you want.
Okay, so as you said, one can pass the exam after studying 14-15 subjects. So what about the rest of the 4-5 subjects? Should one just omit them or we can do the previous year questions or the high topics of those particular subjects as well?
So what I did was a few subjects that I had left. During my mocks, I tried to understand those questions. And when I solved the previous year's questions, I noted the topics that were repeating. I studied those. And at the end pages of FMG solution, there are those key points that are given. So if you, about 6 small subjects are there. If you study 4 thoroughly and you have not done 2, then for those 2, you can, I think, completely rely on the key points from FMG solution.
Okay,
you
but
at
what,
least answer 2-3 questions, 2-3 questions out of 5 or 6 that they ask.
Okay, so according to you, just leaving any subject is not the solution. You can just go through the important points of that particular topic.
Or maybe, yes. And maybe T&D's test and discussions that is provided from your coaching or online prep.
Yeah.
Just reading it because those are actually about 50 or 100 most important questions that are asked. So that would help.
Okay. Very good. So now talking about the revision, like you said, it is very important. More than the knowledge, what matters is the revision. So what should be the revision strategy and how much time one should devote for revision? And how one should go about revision in general?
As I told you, I plan to finish the curriculum on 30th October. And after that, how many subjects I had finished, I just left. And from 2nd November, I started revising. The strategy was same. In the morning, I would study preclinical. In the afternoon, I would study either pharmacology or PSM. And at night, I would study a small subject. So in about 3-4 days, I finished one main subject, one small subject. And pharmacology and PSM, I just continued it all along. So from 2nd of November to 30th November was my first revision. And after that, during this time, I took previous year's papers. From the app itself. excel and I was scoring about 160s 170s in the those tests and but those exams are actually they are recall based, so they are easier than the mock tests that you take from any coaching or the online app that you are using. During my first revision, the things that I was forgetting, those I read from 1st December to 14 December. And I took second mock test, second All India FMG test on 2nd of December. And in that test, I did pass. I scored 165, around 165 in that test. So it's actually predictive. The second mock test is actually predictive because you take it in two weeks of your actual test.
Correct.
Most of my friends have scored either 10 marks ahead of it or a little lower than that.
Like margin, but around margin that from the actual exam score was also somewhere near that.
Because the real exam is, I would say, easier than the All India FMG exam. But at the same time, the stress level is high.
Correct.
During the real exam. So it nullifies and you get approximately the same.
Same score, correct. So, okay. So, you actually did 2 to 3 revisions, right?
3. So, first revision from 2nd November to 30th November. Second revision from 1st December to 14th December. 14th. And third revision from 15th to 19th. So, these 5 days, I just read the key points from FMG solution.
Okay, so... correct. So your first and second revision was from the videos or you just skimmed through the notes?
No, no, just notes because there's no time to go through the videos once again. So no videos, just notes. About 3 days for one preclinical subject and 4-5 days for clinical subjects, big subjects. And I think the small subjects are easier to do. There's no worry. 3 days you can finish every day.
They're scoring
three
as well. Like, you get that
so you shouldn't
result as well.
Skip those subjects.
Yeah.
Those are actually more important than the big subjects.
Correct. They help you, I guess. They really make a difference of, I guess, 15 to 20 marks in the exam as well.
Yes.
So okay, so now you did mention about the stress in the exam. So let's start with that. First of all, how should be the sleep cycle? Like just a month before the exam and why sleep is really important and how you should do that?
Sleep is important because your entire day is invested in this one exam. So... 1 month, I usually slept early throughout the preparation at around 10 every day. But if you are you study at night, then I would suggest 1 month before the exam, just try to sleep early, wake up early, like how you would wake up on the exam day. Try to follow that because it's very important to be attentive on the exam day. I have seen a lot of people actually sleeping in the exam also. So, yeah, you shouldn't be doing that because then you will lose on the questions. You won't be able to finish your test on time.
Correct.
And paper 2 is entirely clinical. All the questions are long clinical vignettes. So you need time for solving that. And second exam, so you might feel a little sleepy in that. So the guy who was sitting next to me was actually sleeping. So I was disturbed because of that. So yeah, I think you should.
Yeah, it makes
so
a
one
difference.
Day before the exam, stop studying at 5 in the evening.
Okay.
Because there's literally nothing you can do at night in that one night. So just I stopped at 5 p.m. and I went for a walk. I came back. I had dinner at 8:30 and I slept at 9:30.
How did you sleep? Because most of the people I know, even myself,
I was probably just rolling in bed because of anxiety. But I slept. I was actually used to that timeline, sleeping early, waking up early. So it wasn't very different for me.
So correct, but okay. Having said that, I guess it is not that easy to do just a couple of days before the exam. So you have to develop a habit at least a month before the exam, right?
Yes, that's right.
Okay, and you already mentioned about the day before the exam, how one should go about it. And how was your actual exam day experience? Like, what all were your feelings at that time? Was it you were remembering the preparation days, or you were anticipating how the paper is going to be, or you were worried about the result? So what kind of mind games were going on inside?
So in the morning when I left from home, of course, there was a lot of worry, anxiety, very nervous. And when I entered the exam hall, I just wanted to make sure that I give my best. Whatever okay. I have studied, I recollected on time and I give it my best shot. Mm-hmm. So during my mock test that I took, I generally scored better in the second paper subjects
okay.
than the first paper. Generally, mm-hmm. people score better in the first paper.
Yes.
So I was a little more nervous mm-hmm. because I knew that I was not very good with learning anatomy, microbiology. So I thought it would be difficult for me. But mm-hmm. When the first paper ended, I think it was much easier than the mock test. Much easier than what I had anticipated it to be.
True.
I thought mm-hmm. it was going to be very difficult, but it wasn't as difficult as I thought. So I was happy. And there were four of us from my university at my center. Mm-hmm. And we were discussing questions in the break. So, okay. Yeah, most of it was right. Even anatomy, actually, I had thought that the questions are going to be tough about nerve injury, or maybe they'll give a case with some muscle spasm or something. But no, it was mostly pointing and it was pretty easy.
Yeah. Okay, so what and, I have perceived is, carry on, sorry.
Okay. So, in the break, I had fruits. The break is about 2 hours, 2 to 2.5 hours. And after mm-hmm. that, I came back and I was confident for the second paper because I knew it was strength. But second paper was very lengthy.
Lengthy in the sense it took... In the break time,
I didn't carry any... I didn't carry any books, nothing.
Okay.
Just relax in that time. And in the second paper... it took a lot of time. I think I finished, it's 2.5 hours. I finished in about 2 hours and half mm-hmm. an hour for the marked questions and the questions that I hadn't solved earlier. Mm-hmm. But through my friends, I got to know that a lot of students were not able to finish it on time, or they skipped because of time constraint. They weren't able to finish the last 10-15 questions.
Yeah. So I guess your complete preparation actually helped you overall, right? Like you used to give the mock test in between, the All India test, the subject-wise test, the topic-wise test. So all in all, you were pretty much ready for the exam.
Yes, I thought I wasn't, but ultimately I was.
Okay, like on the exam day?
Even after the exam, the exam day, I thought, I don't know what's going to happen. Nobody knows what kind of questions are going to be asked. Mm-hmm. So I was nervous, of course. But after coming back, I knew that there was a chance of passing. Maybe I could pass. I wasn't very confident that I would pass.
But you were positive about the outcome.
Yes, yes. So there were about 25-30 questions I knew I had done wrong in the test.
Yeah, those silly mistakes.
So, and I think after the exam, there's 1 month. We took our exam on 28th December and the result was on 28th January. So that 1 month is more stressful because you don't know whether you have to start studying again or you can relax. So it's busy to, if you know that it wasn't really well, then you can actually start studying maybe. But I didn't study. You've already studied for 5 months, so you deserve that break.
It's difficult to start on with the preparation just after the exam. So everyone waits for the exam and for the result, actual result. Okay, so...
And that 1 month enjoy to your fullest. try to think less about the result, which is of course difficult, because immediately after the result, the second day I got the recalls from different students, compile the recalls,
coaching, you see,
and I wanted to know how much I am going to score. So of course I went and I saw the questions, and there were about 200 recalls. So I knew that I would score 110 for sure. And 20-30, I wasn't sure about the questions. Maybe the recalls weren't right. Because in the recalls, they just put highlight the main question. There's no vignette. Clinical vignette is not mentioned. So
they do guess about it. No, no one is sure about the actual recalls.
Actual recall, yes.
Yeah.
So 1 month, I had things to distract me, keep me distracted. So just try to think less about the result and think about the 5 months that you studied.
Okay.
The 5 months that you've actually logged, then you deserve that break. So it's fine. You don't need to regret about that 1 month that you'll be enjoying.
Okay. Very good. Very good points you have mentioned here. One last thing I want to ask you is, how about stress and negativity? How one can help with those things, because I guess these are few things that actually pull you back and they don't let you perform or prepare to the maximum of the efficiency. So how did you go about it?
So negativity can be in a lot of form. For example, I was negative from within because I was doing something different from the rest. True. But then I decided that let's just forget everything. Let's just follow the daily plan and let's see where it takes me. So when I started scoring well in the mock tests, it gave me confidence. So it's important to plan mock tests. I think you should. I took 10 to 15 of them.
Mm-hmm.
So if you solve 4-5 papers, you are confident of your score. So that helps. And I don't really believe in group studies, but I had 3-4 friends of mine who were in coaching centers. So they used to motivate me, and I used to ask them about which subject they are studying, how many days. So I was in touch with them, and that really helped me with the positivity. But sometimes what happens is you start comparing. You start comparing that your friend is already started with the second revision and you are still finishing 14 subject. So that also builds in negativity. But I don't think there is need of comparison. It is not a competitive exam.
Yeah.
So it doesn't matter whether the other person has done 3 revisions or you are just starting with your first revision. You need to focus on what is your plan. And it doesn't matter. Maybe that person will score a 200 plus. But even if you score a 152, it's still okay. Yeah. 160, 170 or whatever.
So what do you say? It's you have to believe in yourself, right? You cannot predict anything. You just focus on the preparation and your own efforts.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah. So that is what we are also doing. We have made a test series, like the mock test and everything. And many of the students are already giving the segment-wise test, and we are going to start with the mock test as well. So all those who are watching this and want to join it, it's completely free of cost. You can just go in the description and you can check the link for the Telegram group and for the application, and you can go ahead with the preparation. Whatever you want, we are always there for you. So it was an amazing session, actually. So if you have to give any message to the ones, those who are preparing for now, and to those who are going to give it in the coming years, so what would that one message be, which can actually play a major role in the satisfaction, actually? Because how important is it to be the result oriented or the preparation oriented? So what is the difference according to you in that?
So enjoy during your university days. You're not going to get those days back. I finished in 5 months. I think if I did it, anybody can do it. The importance is not about finishing everything, but understanding what is high yield and what is not, and focusing more on that, revising it 3-4 times maybe. And during these 5 months, if you know that you have been honest with your preparation and you've actually studied, say, 8 to 10 hours qualitatively, not quantitatively, then just don't worry. Then I think most will be able to scrape through. But even if you don't lose hope. Just analyze the subject that you are not really good at and focus on those in your subsequent attempts. And don't be scared of mock tests. Keep solving it. Even if you've just finished 10 subjects, it doesn't matter. The mock tests are actually going to help you because you know how you'll perform in the real test. So it actually builds a lot of confidence.
Stress, right?
Yes. If you already are used to solving 300 questions at a stretch, then I think you won't have any time constraint in the actual paper.
Second paper particularly. Yeah.
You will know how much time you need to devote to each question and
correct
the exam strategy about ruling out answers.
Yeah.
That only comes through practice.
True. So you have to keep on giving as many tests as possible. So that is your mantra, I guess. And you have to be honest with your preparation, exactly like you said. So I'm very happy that we conducted this session of ours. And I feel personally that many of the students are going to reap in the benefits of it. So if you have any doubts, you can directly get in touch with us. If you want, I can share your details as well in the description down below. So if anyone wants to have anything they want to know. So in the end, I just want to say it is just an exam. So don't worry too much about it. Everyone is going to sail through. So just be positive about the preparation. Very rightly, she has mentioned everything. Focus and be honest to yourself. No need to do anything more than that. Correct?
Right.
So thank you so much, Devika, for again joining us.
Thank you for inviting me.
You're most welcome. We'll surely do many more sessions in the future. Thank you so much.
Hopefully. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.